Hi everyone, welcome to my channel. I am your host Pratik Anjay, and today we are going to continue our discussion on data analysis with Python. I will be showing you few more Python commands that are useful in data science in or machine learning, even that is helpful in data analytics as well. So as you can see, we have already discussed few of the commands in my last video. So for the new viewers, they can directly go to my channel and they can see for this video, data analysis Python for data science. Even they can see other videos as well. There are lots of other videos available with the different sort of information. For example, how to deploy a machine learning model, how to perform a speech recognition, how to do a sentiment analysis, how to build a auto ML application. So you can find plenty of other videos available in my channel as well. So let's back to today's discussion. So let me give you a little brief what has happened in my last video. We have executed few of the commands, like how to read a CSV file, how to check our shape of the data set, how to check the columns, how to find the null values, how to find the numerical and categorical variables, and like that. So today we are going to see few more new Python commands, and basically those are all from the pandas Python commands that we can say. So let's begin. So let's see my data first, and this is my data. So for example, here I have uploaded whole my data, but there will be scenario in the real time where I need not to upload my whole data. I want a particular columns to be uploaded from the data set. So how we can do that? So this is the command for that, where I am giving my data set path and I am telling which are the columns I want to import. So for example, I have given here gender, age and BMI. So only three columns will be imported directly from the whole data set. So let me run this command first and let me see the head for that. So you can see this now. There are only three columns, gender, age and BMI. So and by default it is showing five values, because head directly gives five values at a time. If I want to see more, just I have to give values over there. So it will give you 10 values. So our next command is describe. So let me show you what describes actually do. So let me run this command, and it is giving me basically the statistics of my whole data set. Statistics in the sense, what are the count, what is the mean, what is the standard deviation, what is the minimum value, what is the 25%, what is the 50%. So if I want to understand the statistics of the whole data set, we can use this command. So sometimes it is very pretty good, because it is giving me statistics of each of the column. For example, I can see for ID, I can age. For example, if I want to say, okay, what was the average count for heart disease? So this is the value for that. Similarly, we can check for glucose level. Similarly, we can check for BMI. This is the 28.60 was the average BMI from the whole data set. So my majority of the values are lying over there, that we can say. Even for the stroke we can find different sort of information available. So this is very much important to understand the statistics behind each of the data variables, because in our long run, or as we proceed to our machine learning or regression thing, so these things are very very much important at that point of time. So now we can move to our next function, that is info. Let me show you what it gives you. This is basically giving us the data types of each of the variable. For example, what is my ID, what is my gender, what is my age. So if it is integer, it is showing you int. If it is a float, it will be giving you float. And if it is numeric, then it is giving you object. So at a one sort, you can know, okay, which are my integer, which are my categorical variable using this info command. And as already I have shown you, this command will give you the null values on each of the columns. So you can see, okay, BMI are having some null values, smoking status has some null values. So what if I want to see which are the null values available in my BMI column? So here I am seeing, okay, 1462 values are null. But what are those values? I want to see only those values in the data set where BMI's values are null. So this command will give you that information. Let me run that. So this is giving me the information where BMI is null. See, all the data set, all the data available for this column is null because I have given the parameter BMI here as null. If I want to see for a smoking status, just I will copy this and I will paste here. Sorry. So now you will get all the data available for null for a smoking status column. So like that, you can check for any of the variables available in your data set. Here we have only two variables, so I am showing you null values for two of the columns. Let me go for our next command. Let me run this head thing first. And our next command is iloc. So let me show you what exactly iloc does. This is basically used for running each of the rows. As of now, we were running our data set from the column perspective. Now we are running our data set from the row perspective. Let me run that. And you are getting the details over here. Because I have given one, so it has picked this value. Sorry, the first index value. 30468, 30468. So likewise, if I want to look for example, this value, 3. I will put that 3 over there and I will run it. It will give me the details of 3. For example, 56543, 56543. So like this, we can run values with respect to the row. And we are using the index value here in the bracket. What if I want to see 3-4 rows at the same time? What command can be for that? So our next command will give you from 0 to 4 rows values from the whole data set. Let me run you for that, and it will giving me 1 2 3 4 records from the whole data set. If I will give here 10, it will give me 10 records. See, it will give me 10 records, but it is giving me from the perspective of row, from the row value. Now what if I want to look for a specific value from the whole data set? I want to look for example, this thing, this male. So this command is used to basically pick the specific value from the whole data set. Let me run and see what output it is giving me. This is basically data.iloc. In the bracket, I'm giving me 1, that is the index, 2 is the position for which I want the value. So it is giving me 58 because it is picking this value, because this is the 0, 1, 2, it is the index 1. For example, if I want to pick this value, I will give index, this is the index 6, and the position is 0, 1, 2. Let me run that. And 52, this is giving 52. Likewise, if I want to look for this glucose for this row, so this is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. I will just give over there 8. And it is giving me that position value, 77.59. So basically what is that? 6 is my index, 6 is the position in the row for which a specific value I want the result. So likewise, you can pick or you can check for any values from the entire data set. Our next command. So this is A very important command. In many of the interviews, people ask this question, how you will iterate rows. So this is the command to iterate rows, like we are iterating the data set from the row perspective. And this is the command that is for index row in data dot iterate rows, print index and row. Let me run that for you. And it will run from the row perspective, and it will run each and every row from the entire data set. This is for 0, this is for 1. If I will go down, this is for 2, this is for 4, this is for 6. Likewise, it has run through for each of the records, how many records are available over there in the data set. So what if I want to iterate a particular column? For example, let me first bring the data set for you, then it will be easy to explain me. So my data set is ready now. See, data.head, my data set is ready, and I want to iterate a particular column that is called gender. I want to see the values for that particular column only. So what I will do, I will just give this command. I will put row inside that. I will put the gender thing. Let me show you what result it will give. It will give me all the records available in this gender column. All the records available in this gender column will run. Likewise, if I want to look for this work type, I will just change this gender thing to work type, and it will run through each of the record, like whole data set it will run through. See how many records are there. It has 12,000. It is keep going. There are so many records over there. So it is running through each of the records from that particular column. So this is very much important when we are writing some sort of programming, and where we want to put a value from a particular column, where we are feeding values from a particular column in some other place, where this command is very much handy. So again, I want to filter a record from a particular data set. For example, I want to see where the gender is male from the entire data set. Let me run you for that. So it will give me the whole record, whole data set where gender is equal to male. So this is kind of a filtering. You can say we have filtered the gender column with the male value. It will give you male. If I will change it for female, it will give me for female. So it is giving me for the female record. Similarly, we can look for anyone. For example, if I type work type and if I am giving the value as children, let me run you for that. So it is giving me all the records where the work type is equal to children. So this is also very much important. You need not to go and look for each time your whole data set. Just filter it out, check it out, use it, and then reset it back to the main data set. So again, this is command is very much important. This is for the sorting purpose. What if I want to sort the whole database as per average glucose level? So let me run you for that. So the whole data set has been sorted with respect to average glucose level. This is the average glucose level, and as of now it is in ascending order. What if I want to sort all the values from the data set in descending values? Just we have to add it here, ascending is equal to false. So once it means by default it is ascending, and ascending it means that is true. If I want to see the values in descending order, what we have to do, we have to just simply keep ascending is equal to false. And if you see here, our first data was 55. In this scenario, our first data is 291.05. It means it has directly reversed the order over here. We can even make the sorting from two different columns also, because here I have given age and average glucose level also. So first it will filter with age, and then it will filter with average glucose level. So by default it will be in ascending order. So age is 0.8, and again the values are for that prospective age. It is coming over there. So this is the whole commands that are very much handy, and that you are going to use very much in day to day your data science or machine learning practice. Because if you are a student, or if you are new to this field, and if you are trying to move into data science field, so it is very important to learn all these commands. Because every time, whenever you are using any new data set or even old data set, this commands will be very much handy. And don't forget to also watch the previous video on this topic. And I will be bringing the part 3 also, where I will be covering some more Python commands. I will explain you everything, how with those sort of commands we can manipulate or understand or read our data sets. So please keep watching all the videos. Put your like, support and subscribe for this channel, because once you will do that, that motivates me to bring more and more videos. And also I will be bringing all sort of videos that will help you guys to make your career into data science field, or give you more understanding towards this field. So yeah, thank you. Thanks for watching. And please like and subscribe my channel. Thank you very much.